My name is Nubya Garcia and I'm a musician. I play the saxophone. I am a band leader and a composer. I play a bit of flute and try to play the piano. Yeah, I just want to talk about how I write music. For me, it can come from anything. Maybe it starts with like a drum loop. Maybe it starts with me playing a couple chords. And sometimes it starts with a melody. But for the tune, the message continues from my album. This track actually started with chords. I think I was messing around on the piano, just going through some sounds, some chord kind of types, just trying to find a way through them, basically. So I think chords can be quite intimidating sometimes. And me, as a saxophone player, I find it just helps to like slow things down loads and just really get into each chord and think like, okay, where can we go from here? Because you can go so many different places from each chord. You have to trust your ear. Your ear is leading you. I think you know what you like and don't like. And also sometimes it's really good to challenge yourself to see like something that maybe doesn't sound okay to you at first. Like, why doesn't it sound okay? Is it just you staying in your comfort zone? Or is it like actually the chord is like gnarly and it doesn't fit here? But for me, for the message continues, I think it starts here, right? On F minor. And I was just like, If it went here afterwards, rather than here, it's kind of like a little bit like it's got a little uplifting vibe. I think it's also helpful sometimes to like go through the chordal types. Say if you really like this movement, those are the two, that's where you want to go, F to F sharp. First chord F minor. Does it work if you go to F sharp minor for you? Does it work if it goes from F minor to a major next? To me, I kind of like the sound of that more, so I ran with that. The only thing I added was I just dropped the fifth down a semitone to just add a little bit more spice. And then I took it down to repeat the same kind of bass movement. So it was here. What does it sound like if you do that? Again, somewhere else. So I think repetition is like a really great thing to use in composition. Like I think people can be tempted to be like, new idea, new idea, new idea, new idea, new idea. Whereas like, you need to be able to recognize some bits, you know? I think it helps the structure of the tune, if the melody calls for it, if the tune calls for it. So the whole thing sounds like this. So in the tune that we do, when I took it to the band, I was like, I want this to be like the intro section. So it can be as long as you want. It can be like repeat it. Sometimes on a gig we may just play this for ages to settle it and then go in to the main bit of the tune, which has the main melody. And the main section is this. Melody-wise, I'm a big believer in singing a melody first, finding an idea that you can sing so that it's kind of like melodic and lyrical at the very foundation of it. That's something that I really enjoy as a quality in my melodies. That's the whole thing. And then it just goes back to this. Thank you. So that's like the whole form. And so those two intro and outro sections kind of bookend the whole main elongated kind of form. And melody-wise, something that I find really helpful when chords come first or like a groove comes first or whatever, is to just record like me playing piano, or if it's like just a bass line or something, on my phone, and then play it back to myself so that I can like write a melody on my saxophone or make up chords or whichever one you're doing. So, yeah. That was kind of like playing through the chords, improvising. I would usually have a recorder on and just go through that and see if anything came up that I liked. I'd do it a few times. The more you do it, the more you can go through the chords, the more you can, you know, you can pick a note to start on, and then you can be like, how can I get through this chord progression without moving too much, or with moving loads? And that's kind of what I did for this tune. Took it like bit by bit, build upon it, and, you know, made sure I could sing the whole melody, I guess. I kind of, like I said before, I really think that is a really important quality of a melody for me, for this kind of tune. And then I'll put it all together. Maybe I'll write it down, maybe I won't. Maybe I'll wait until I have it really solid and then, you know, write down the rhythms and stuff so that when I come back to it, I can start from where I finished rather than like trying to remember what I did. You can just mess around to start with if you're beginning with melody anyway, and find something that you really like and that kind of stands out to you. Try not to think about it being like good or bad yet, and kind of just get the ego out of it, because you can make something really beautiful from anything before you start like fighting yourself on it, whether it's good or bad. I think that's just concentrate on creating. And then once you've got the basis, you can like shift a note around here and there to kind of just improve it. I think the chords and the melody together tell you where they want to go. You know, sometimes also I think you have to be open to listening, you know, where could it go next? What's the next note of this? What rhythm? What is it actually calling for? What does the tune need? So then, at the end of all of it, you're like, you have the whole melody, and to practice it, I just do the same thing I did when I was trying to find the melody, and I'll just play around and round and round it until it's like really settled and it feels like it has a form. So yeah, this is the full melody of the tune that I kind of wrote to these chords. Thank you. So for this example, this tune, you bring it all together and then you start thinking about groove if you hadn't got there already, drums, or structure. You want things to change within your tune. You want the highs and the lows in like all manners of speaking. What will lift it to the next stage? What's your B section? What's your main section and the other section? It can be like opposites. It can be like, as in terms of the groove changes. It can be an instrument drops out if you're doing it with a band. It can be the style in which that you've written the melody. Like, there's so many different things that you can do to differentiate two parts of the tune. And I guess what it's about is if they fit together, like how can you make them best fit together? I don't know if I actually have a format for what I do. I think my thing is that I don't want everything to sound the same. I don't want all my tunes to be like 16 bars, A section, 8 bars, B section, and another 8, you know, like a classic jazz standard head or whatever. If you need a structure and you don't know what it should be, start there and try and write something within that. And then once you've done that, do it again and get, you know, practice that kind of writing within that structure. How can you make it sound different from the last thing that you did? And then once you've done that practice, you can be like, well, what happens if I do 16 and 16? Or like 16 and 10, like why can't I do that? You can. Inspiration, find something that inspires you. You know, maybe it's reading a poem or a book or going to a gallery and sitting and looking at the same painting for ages and then writing something to that. Or writing a story, being like, this is what I want my tune to say. Or you can take a chord structure that exists already and write a new melody to it. Sometimes it's gonna flow and sometimes it's just really not. But like, composition is like a muscle. You have to use it regularly, otherwise it's just gonna like wither. Even when you come back to it, you'll be like, oh, why can't I think of anything? And so you have to kind of get to know yourself, what feeds you, what opposes you, what gets in your way, and it's like usually yourself. There's just so much going on everywhere, like within every art form, and within music everything's just quite saturated and it can feel like, oh, what do I even bring to the table? Whereas like, no one is you, you know? You shouldn't be focusing on trying to be something. You should figure out what you are doing, you know? Whether that's within a tradition or not, you can still achieve that. But why don't you try and do something else? What do you bring that is different to anyone? But yeah, patience is key. Practice what you do. One of the most beautiful things about music is that it's a whole community. Even if you play one type of music and this person plays one type of music, you can meet in the middle and make something beautiful together if you choose to do so. It's another plane, you know? You can have so many different types of experiences to it. Music can make you feel happy, sad, angry. You can have a transcendental experience, and you can also just put it on and just like nod your head and vibes to it with your mates. Like, it's everything without being too deep. Yeah.